Hi guys, I think I've got this figured out on the lawn boy cylinder, the sleeve installation there. The problem was I dropped the end mill the last time, but I've got a better way to hold it. So let me show you what I'm talking about here. I took the tool that I had made to bore and hone, and I cut it out a little bit, relieved it so I could get in there to cut these, and should have a little better control over everything. That other thing was pretty sketchy, but I think it was getting it done. I didn't have any trouble with any of them until I broke my bit there. But anyhow, I won't be able to put a bolt there, I don't believe. I may be able to do it if I grind a little bit of the bolt away. Let me see what I can figure out there. But even with three bolts, I think we'll be in good shape. But this I'll be able to hold down. Without having an issue, I think. It was very tight getting this one in right here, but we got her done. All right, so let me get her set up over here. Very easy here. Thank you. There's our fourth one. Just got to take it slow on this stuff. When you're in an angle, and if you mess something up, you got to start over with a new sleeve. So you just want to make sure that everything is the way it should be and take it easy. Get this cleaned up a little bit. All right, now let's take a look at this thing. Hope you can see good enough in there. So there's our new transfers. And I'm not going to worry about deburring the edge there yet, because we've still got to fit the piston, and I've still got to cut the exhaust ports too. So, and just to look at where we went in, I just set the angle best I could. What I did, it wasn't scientific at all. I just set the Bridgeport up, set the cylinder up first, and set the Bridgeport up with a 3/8 rod in it. And you can see here. And I just kept going until I got a free fit through my ports with the rod. And then once I did that, you know, the 3/8 end mill, you know, is basically the same thing. So we just set it up, and once you get that angle, the angle turned out to be 47 degrees. That's what I ended up with. So there we go. A new cylinder and a lawn boy. Now if I can cut three more exhaust ports and fit the piston without screwing it up, it'll be a good thing, I think. Sorry, I just noticed I didn't have the audio on. Haven't really said much. I just like I said before that you didn't hear me was these are center cutting end mills. You'd never be able to do this kind of a plunge cut with a standard end mill. Makes me a little nervous that I can't see what I'm doing, you know, on the inside. But it seems to be cutting all right, so I think everything will be all right. Everything looks good. We got three holes. Let me get that cleaned up and out of there and we'll take a look at it. All right, let's take a look at this now. There's our ports. I just did a quick measure down from the bottom of the sleeve here down to the ports, and I compared it to another cylinder, and everything is within just a couple of thousandths, so everything should be good. So far, so good. So we're just down to refitting a new piston, or fitting a new piston. So that will be the next step.